My dear students, I welcome you in the lecture series of Basics of Mechanical Engineering. In the last session, we discussed about the steam formation and different types of enthalpy associated with the steam formation. Today, we are going to talk about the boiler and its different mountings and the accessories. So, first of all, what is a boiler? So, boiler is a device used for generating steam from the water. This steam is utilized for power generation, for process heating, or for space heating. Sometimes only hot water is produced in a boiler and utilized for the heating processes. Now, according to the Indian Boiler Regulation, IBR, a boiler is a closed pressure vessel with capacity exceeding 22.75 liters and used for generating steam under pressure. It includes all the mountings fitting to such vessels which remain wholly or partially under pressure when steam is shut off. So, the capacity of the boiler used for power generation is considerably large. The steam is also produced at a high pressure due to the requirement of high efficiency. The boilers used for process heating are generally smaller in size, simpler in design, and generate steam at a much less pressure. So, this is all about the introduction to the boiler, application, and what is the condition according to the Indian Boiler Regulation. Now let's talk about the essential qualities of a good boiler. So here I would like to share some qualities of a good boiler. It should produce maximum steam with minimum fuel consumption. It should be able to deliver the desired quality of steam very quickly. It should be able to meet large load fluctuation whenever it is demanded. It should be light in weight and simple in construction. It occupy less spare area. It should be easy to maintain and inspect. The joint should be accessible for inspection and should be face the impact of flame directly. The tubes should be sufficiently strong to resist wear and the corrosion. And last but not the least, it should comply with safety regulations laid by the authority. So these all are the essential qualities of a good boiler. Now let's talk about the classification of a boiler. So the boiler may be classified in different ways. So the first is the content of the tube. So it may be either fire tube boilers or a water tube boiler. So fire tube boiler means hot gases pass through the tube which are surrounded with the water. The examples are Cochran locomotive and the Lancashire boilers are fire tube boilers. On the other side, water tube boiler. So, water circulates through the tube and the hot gases surround them. So, steam is generated inside the tubes and collected in cylindrical vessel which is known as the boiler drum. The example is Babcock-Wilcox boiler. The second is position of axis. So, boiler may be horizontal boiler or vertical boiler. If the principal axis is horizontal, so that is known as the horizontal boiler, like locomotive boiler or a Lancashire boiler. But if the axis or the principal axis is vertical, so that boiler is known as the vertical boiler. The example is Cochran boiler. The third is the type of the water circulation. So there are two types of the water circulation. One is a natural circulation of water, means the water is circulated in a natural way. and the other is forced circulation boiler. So the water is circulated through the boiler circuit by a pump. The low capacity boiler use the natural circulation, while high capacity or high pressure boilers use forced circulation for the effective steam generation. The fourth is a steam pressure. So there are three types of the pressure: high pressure steam boiler, medium pressure steam boiler, and the low pressure steam boiler. If the working pressure for this boiler is more than 25 bar, so that is the high pressure boiler, in between 10 to 25 bar, so that is medium pressure boiler, and if it is less than 10 bar, so that is known as the low pressure steam boiler. Now the fourth is the mobility of the boiler. So it may be stationary boiler or a mobile boiler. The most of the industrial boilers are stationary boilers, just like a Lancashire boiler, Babcock Wilcox boiler, and another one is mobile boiler. So they use to run locomotive and the ships, just like the locomotive boilers. So in simple word, stationary boilers are fixed boilers, where mobile boilers are movable boilers. The next is furnace position. So if the furnace is placed outside of the boiler, so that is known as the externally fired boilers. The example is Babcock and Wilcox boiler. But the furnace is placed inside the boiler cell, so that is known as the internally fired boiler. The example is Cochran boiler. And last but not the least, type of the fuel used. So it may be a coal based boiler, it may be a gas based boiler, or it may be a liquid fuel based boiler. So this is all about the classification of the boiler. Now let's talk about the essential part of a boiler. So here we will describe the parts of a boiler in short, so that you can understand them in context of a complete boiler later on. So now the first is cylindrical cell. So the cylindrical cell is nothing but the cell in which different parts of the boiler are enclosed and on which the mountings are seated. So this is nothing but the cylindrical cell. The second is a grate. Grate is a platform. Grate is a platform on which the fuel is burnt. The third is a fire hole. So the fire hole is the hole through which coal is added to the furnace whenever it is needed. So somewhere here we may have a fire hose. Fire. Next is the firebox. So the firebox is nothing but the chamber, contains hot gases, produced by combustion of the fuel. The chamber is surrounded by the water. The wall of the firebox are at very high temperature due to the radiative heat transfer from flames and due to the contact with hot gases. This wall conducts the heat to the water surrounding them. The next is the ash pit. Ash pit is located below of the grate so that the ash of the burnt coal is collected. Smoke box. So this is known as a smoke box. So after using the heat available with the flue gases to raise steam, they enter a chamber is called the smoke box. They are then released to atmosphere through the chimney. The next is the chimney. So this is the smoke box. This is the, you can see that the hot gas pipe, and this is the chimney. And last is the manhole. So manhole is located somewhere here. It is a hole provided in the boiler cell so that a workman can go inside the boiler for inspection, cleaning and maintenance. It is generally oval in shape and door is provided. Here we have a door. So door is provided to close it. So these are the essential part of a boiler. And I hope you understand the importance of this part. Now let's talk about the boiler mounting. So the boiler mountings or fittings which are mounted on the boiler for its proper and the safe functioning. They are necessary for the operation and safety of the boiler, and they are generally called as the boiler mountings. So in short, for the safety purpose and for the proper operation, we have to have mount some devices, and these devices are known as the boiler mounting. So here the first is the water level indicator to measure the water level, pressure gauge to measure the pressure, safety valves to, you know, for the safe operation, stop valve to stop the flow of the steam, blow off cork to remove the, you know, mud and you know, like a contaminated water, then, you know, out of the boiler for the, you know, cleaning and the inspection purpose. The feed check valve, that is the, you know, like a water feed valve. In short, feed check valve is a water feed valve, and last is a feasible plug. So now let's talk about the pressure gauge and the water level indicator. So here I would like to suggest you, in this particular presentation I will discuss about only the function, the construction and working you need to self study, because, you know, I don't think so it needs, you know, a very detailed discussion on construction and the working. You may find it in your reference book. So the function of the pressure gauge is to measure the pressure inside the boiler, where the water level indicator, it indicates water level inside the boiler to the observer. So here you can observe that this is nothing but the water level indicator. So from the outer side of the boiler, you can identify the level of the water inside the boiler. So two water level indicators are fitted in front of the boiler. The water level indicators show the level of the water in the boiler drum and warns the operator if by chance the water level goes below a fixed mark, so that the corrective actions may be taken in the time to avoid any incidents. The second is a safety valve and steam stop valve. So if we talk about the safety valve, so safety valves are used to maintain safe pressure inside the boiler. When the pressure of the steam inside the boiler increases beyond the safe value, the valve open and blow off excess steam. All boilers should have at least two safety valves, and they are mounted directly over the boiler. The examples are, you know, like a deadweight safety valve, lever loaded safety valve, then spring loaded safety valve. These are the different types of the safety valves generally, you can say that, installed in the boiler. Here I would like to, you know, connect, or here I would like to explain more about the safety valve. So in your pressure cooker, the pressure whistle is nothing but the safety valve. If the pressure inside the pressure cooker goes beyond certain limit, automatically that safety valve blows off and removes some excess amount of the steam. The second is a steam stop valve. So the steam stop valve is nothing but the we can say that control the passage of the steam from the boiler to the steam pipe, means it regulates the flow of the steam. The next is a blow off cork, feed check valve, and the feasible plug. So a blow off cork is nothing but you know, the water fed to boiler always contains some sediments and dissolved salts. So the water is evaporated, but this get accumulated near the bottom of the boiler. So the blow off cork is used to periodically discharge a portion of water from the bottom of the boiler, which has higher density of sediments and salts. Or in other words, it is required to empty the boiler periodically for cleaning purpose and for inspection purpose, as I have already told you. The second is a feed check valve. So the feed check valve controls the water from the pump to the boiler. It does not allow the backflow from the boiler to the pump when the pump pressure is less than the boiler pressure. Means the feed check valve controls the water flow inside the boiler. And last but not the least, that is nothing but the feasible plug. So a feasible plug is nothing but a boiler mounting which is required when the water level in the boiler falls below an unsafe level, and due to that, the pressure inside the boiler may increase beyond certain limit. So during that point, the fissible plug may melt and the excessive amount of the steam can go outside of the boiler. So for the safe operation, we have to install the fissible plug on the top side of the boiler. So this plug is generally fitted over the crown of the furnace or over the top part of the boiler. Now let's talk about some boiler accessories. So boiler accessories are those which are auxiliary parts or which are an integral parts of a boiler and help in the running efficiently. So boiler accessories are auxiliary parts required for the smooth operation and to increase its efficiency. So in simple words, boiler mountings are necessarily required for the safety of purpose, but boiler accessories are not compulsory. If you install the boiler accessories, you may increase the efficiency of the boiler. So this is the major difference between boiler mountings and boiler accessories. One more time, I would like to repeat, boiler mountings are those which are completely required and boiler accessories are those which are not completely required. But if you install, you may increase the efficiency of the boiler. Now here we have a feed pump. So feed pump is nothing but you can say that a simple device to supply the water in the boiler. The second is a superheater. Superheater uses the waste energy to heat the water, so that we can say that the temperature of the initial water may increase and it may reduce the consumption of the fuel. So that is nothing but the superheater. The third is the economizer. The economizer consists of a large number of vertical cast iron or steel pipes in which they are connected with two horizontal pipes, one at a top and another at a bottom. The feed water is pumped into the economizer through the bottom pipe. From the bottom pipe, the water comes into the pipe A through the vertical pipes and finally goes to the boiler. The exhaust gas flow in these pipes so that indirectly the heat transfer occurs from the hot gases to this feed water. It means ultimately we want to increase the temperature of the feed water or like a fresh water, so that less amount of energy is required to convert that heated water into the steam. And the last is the air preheater. As we know that for proper combustion, we need three components. First is a fuel, second one is the atmosphere, and third is a spark. So if you supply the hot air, or you can say that a predefined air, preheated air, so that you can easily ignite the fuel. So air preheater uses the same kind of the principle. So instead of heating the water, with the help of the air preheater, you can heat up the air also. And it may indirectly enhance the, quality of the burning. So these all are the boiler accessories. Now let's talk about the Cochrane boiler. So here we have only one boiler, so that we are going to discuss. So it is nothing but the Cochrane boiler. Cochrane boiler is also known as the vertical multi-tubular boiler. So the Cochrane boiler is a vertical multi-fire tube boiler used for a low rate steam generation. It is made in different size with steam evaporation capacity ranging from 150 kg to 3000 kg per hour and working pressure up to the 20 bar. So we can say that it is a medium pressure boiler. The boiler consists of a cylindrical shell with a hemispherical shape crown. The firebox is also hemispherical in shape. The hemispherical crown of a boiler gives a good strength to withstand pressure of steam inside the boiler. The hemispherical shape of the furnace can withstand intense heat and is also advantageous for absorption of radiant heat from the furnace. The grate is placed at the bottom of the furnace, and ash pit is located below the grate. The coal is fed to the fire door, and ash is formed, which is collected from the ash pit. The furnace and the combustion chamber are connected. The furnace and combustion chamber are connected by the short flue pipe. This is nothing but the short flue pipes. The back of the combustion chamber is lined with the back, or you can say that the fire brick lining. So here this fire brick lining is made by that material having low thermal conductivity, so heat cannot radiate outside. The hot gases enters to the combustion chamber through the flue pipe with considerable velocity. The hot gases in the combustion chamber flow through the nest of horizontal fire tubes. So here the fire tube boilers. Why? Because the hot gases pass through the tubes. So it is known as a fire tube boiler. The gases pass through the fire tube transfer a large amount of the portion of heat to the water by the convection mode of the heat transfer. This is not the conduction mode of the heat transfer. This is the convection mode of the heat transfer. Then the hot gases go to the smoke box, and then they are discharged to the atmosphere through the chimney. A manhole is provided near the top of the crown of the shell for cleaning and the inspection purpose. A number of handholes are provided around the outer shell for the cleaning purpose. The smoke box is provided with doors. So here you may have a door. So smoke box is provided with a door for cleaning of the interior part of the flue tubes or a fire tubes. So let's talk about the advantage and the disadvantage of the Cochran boiler. So the first advantage is it is very simple in construction and light in weight. The low initial cost, less floor space required, and quick and easy installation. So these are the advantages. But what are the disadvantages? The interior is not easily accessible for the cleaning, inspection, and the repairing purpose. Water capacity is small, so making it very difficult to keep a steady steam pressure. Water along with steam may enter the steam pipe under heavy loads due to a small steam space, and efficiency is low in smaller size. So these all are the advantages and the disadvantages of the Cochran boiler. And I think you have some self-study, so you must know more about the boiler. You must know more about the different types of the boiler, the importance of the boiler mountings and boiler accessories. So I think that's all from my end as far as this particular discussion is concerned. I hope you understand the importance of boiler, boiler mountings, boiler accessories, and construction and working of the Cochran boiler. Thank you for attending the session. Have a great weekend ahead. Thank you. Bye.